to hear about. And we're looking at, again, the petro dollar versus the petro rupee. So we're going to hear from a gentleman from Energy Studies at Gateway House. So I want you to give a very, very warm welcome for Amit Bhandari. So Amit, I think, is in the house. I'm hoping he is indeed.
Yeah. Thank you.
And lovely to see you again, Amit. Thank you so much.
Thank you
this
so much.
This sounds fascinating. I'll listen from behind.
So thanks for the introduction. The paper I'm about to present, my presentation takes from a paper which looks at possibility of trading oil on an Indian exchange using an Indian rupee. But before we move ahead, a short quiz. The currency of Abu Dhabi is the dirham. Does anybody know what was the currency before the dirham? Any guesses? It was the Indian rupee. Till 1969, the Reserve Bank of India used to print a special rupee note, which was used not just in Abu Dhabi, but in all the Emirates, in Oman, in Qatar, in Bahrain, Yemen, and Kuwait. And actually, if we go back a few years further, before 1947, the Indian rupee, which is the coin on top left, was actually the currency across much of the Indian Ocean rim. Many of the countries used to have the rupee as their currency, and those which didn't, which are the colonial empires of Italy, Portugal, and Germany, used to have a coin identical to the Indian rupee in weight, size, design, and in silver content. So 100 years back, the Indian rupee was an international currency. But after 1947, as India withdrew from the world and Indian economy went into a relative decline, the role of the rupee also shrunk. But that has started to change. Since the 1990s, India has been on something of a comeback trail. Indian economy has grown in real and absolute terms, and we hope to be a $5 trillion economy in a few years' time. What does that mean in practical terms? In 1968, the very thin slice that you see, somewhere over 20, is India's oil consumption. India consumed less oil than small and mid-sized European nations such as Sweden, Belgium, or even the Netherlands. In 2018, India consumed almost as much oil as Germany, France, and UK combined. So by any measure of consumption, India is growing. By 2040, India is expected to be a 10 million barrels a day economy. It is not just India which has grown. Asian countries have grown, some of them at a much faster pace. So the oil trade across the world has shifted. The financial trade has not. We still use Brent and WTI as the benchmarks for pricing of oil. Now, in a world where US is no longer the largest importer of oil, in fact, it may no longer be an importer at all in a few years' time, can WTI be used for pricing oil in trade between two Asian countries? Or for that reason, Brent? Oil consumption in Europe has been falling for some decades now. The Brent field is supposed to stop production in a few years' time. Can we use that as a benchmark? So what we really need is an Asian benchmark which mirrors the Asian patterns of consumption and production and what Asian consumers and producers really want. And we feel that India is best suited to be the host for this kind of a benchmark, given its unique advantages. The large consumption is just one of them. You need some other factors to make a successful marketplace. The first, of course, is that for a trading platform, you need buyers and sellers. If the trading is between one seller, let's say ADNOC, and one buyer, which is Indian Oil, you cannot have a marketplace. Indian economy, given its size and diversity, has thousands of small, medium, and large participants who will bring liquidity to this exchange. This is something which only a few other markets can offer. The second issue is favorable regulation. Not every market allows commodity trading. In not every market does the government have the wisdom to stay out of the marketplace. In the stock market, Indian government has shown the wisdom by staying out of interfering with the day-to-day market mechanisms. And in fact, Indian government is also trying to cut back its role in the world of business as well. The best example of that is the proposed disinvestment in Bharat Petroleum, a Fortune 500 oil refining company, which the government intends to sell in the next few months. And as a result, you will see that India is the home to two of the most dynamic stock exchanges in the region, the Bombay Stock Exchange, which actually is the oldest stock exchange in Asia, and the National Stock Exchange, which has a very vibrant market in derivatives, options, and futures. You cannot have a commodity market without derivatives again. Okay, so all these factors are there. They allow India to create a trade in oil. How does that benefit the rest of us? The first issue is if we create a benchmark that is reflecting the consumption patterns of Asian countries, it is going to be a more reliable price than a benchmark which is set across in Brent or in London or in New York, representing the consumption patterns of maybe 30 or 50 years back. Transparent pricing is a big win for everyone. There is a second advantage which India also stands to gain. India is one of the few large economies which doesn't have a strategic petroleum reserve. It would be good to have it, but our government has many demands on its resources. Now, if you set up an exchange like this in India, physical settlement of the contracts will require large amounts of storage to be created. And in case of an unforeseen emergency, maybe events of last 2 weeks, maybe what happened in September 2019, this kind of a reserve will be an enormous stabilizing factor for the Indian economy. The biggest gainer, however, will be the Indian consumer. As an Indian consumer, as an Indian investor, the biggest risk I usually stand are fluctuations in energy prices. And so far, there is very little I could have done about them. If this kind of a trade is available to me in my currency, in my exchange, millions of Indian consumers will be in a position finally to overcome the risk that volatility in energy markets poses to them. And most of all, if there is transparent pricing, that's a win for everyone, seller and buyer alike, right? This, by the way, is a picture of India at night. And if you look at satellite pictures of India over the years, you will see that the lighting over India keeps going up and up and up gradually. So this is really a sign that India is really coming out and is coming out for good. Thank you.